Hi folks, today I like let with you the solution I adopt to reuse the VFD interface. Okay, at this time I'm using the interface with the reference PT6315. Okay, is a small IC, a surface, and have 11 pins in each of the four faces, and I extract all the pins from the IC to my breadboard. You can see that here four blocks to connect the wires, and here in the breadboard also you have four blocks of the wires I have used to the extract pins. Okay, the solution I'm using is this small board. Here is a teeny small board of PCB with two faces, and in each face have one adapter. In this case is DKFP32 with 64 pins with between space. This is 0.8 millimeters for each pin, and the other side you have the same adapter, the DKFP32, but now to 100 pins, and the space between pins is 0.5 millimeters. Okay, if you see, you can use the board to implement the AC, and you connect here to make the alignment of the pins with the small PCB, and after you can use this kind of the connectors to extract all the pins you need to your project. Okay, in this case I have a mesh of the wires here, but you can extract only the pins you need. For example, in this case you can do it with 7 pins to control the 7 segment digits, 3 pins to the power, the last 12 volts, ground and VCC, 3 pins to the control, the data in, clock and strobe, and also you need the pins to the numbers of the grids you will use. Okay, in this case I extract all the pins, but you can do it only to the pins is necessary. Okay, for example, 8 grids, 8 pins, 7 segments, 7 pins, 3 power cells and 3 control pins. Okay, and this is enough to make the connection between your small PCB adapter to your breadboard. Okay, here I like let with you the schematic of the IC or the adapter interface I'm using to this VFD. You see here the grid pin, segment pins. Here you have 9 grids, 19 pins to the segments, and here you have that in, clock, strobe, power, GND, VCC, power, GND, VCC, and last 12 volts. Okay, you have another pins, in this case I'm not using, but for example you have 4 pins to control the LEDs, and you have a possible to reuse the segment pins to construct the matrix to the interact with your solution. I like remember to the care is necessary to connect this kind of the VFDs. Remember the number of the pins from the grids direct to the external part. Here in this grid you can see I have 2 connections to the external pins. Okay, by this reason I only connect 1 of the pins of this grid. Okay, because if I connect 2 wires, if I don't have care and force my interface to have two signal difference in these pins, I make a connection, for example, of the ground and the last 12 volts, and this is not good to the IC. Okay. The implement of my VFD is to use as a small clock, and to control this clock, I make use of the IC from the 8mm. In this case, is the 1284. Now 8mm is belongs to the microchip, but you can see here the 8MHz 1284, and it's very easy to use these pins. You only needed the XTAL, VCC, GND, and after you can use any ports to generate your pins of your control. Okay, I have added to the solution box with four buttons. Okay, the box is only to be more easy to implement, and the first button increase the minutes, the second button increase the hours, the third button decrease the weekday. Okay, because I use here the weekday also in this small clock, and the last button do the reset of the counter in seconds to make more easy to synchronize on another clock. Okay, it's very easy to use. After this part, I expose the blocks of the code I used to do it this small clock, and I like say you can replace this processor direct by the Arduino. Okay, you can use the Arduino instead of this processor. You only need to adapt the code and generate the three pins to the control the interface of the VFD. Okay, maybe it's more easy for the lot of the people to use the Arduino instead of this processor, and look to the code and try do it. Okay, good luck.
Okay, here is the lines of the code to work with the clock where I'm using a VFD2. Okay, this is the class I have done, or the functions to I have done to the code, and I will expand one by one to have the chance to look to the lines of the code. Okay. Here is the function of the main. I expand all the functions. Okay, it's done. And now start running from the top of the file to the down. I have some classes or some functions I'm not using during the clock, but it's a generic file I use to another test, and by this reason the class is present. Here is only a decoder of the 8 bits to the 7 segments. Here is interrupt vector. This function sends the 2 points, so blinking by mark the seconds in the VFD. Here is update of the information VFD2. The block of seconds, minutes. Hours. And at last is the main function, okay?